without God, I want to preach your message today called Jesus Saves. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, Lord, to anoint the word that I speak. I ask you, Lord, Holy Spirit, to convict them of their sins. Let them not switch the channel. Let them not turn from the station. In Jesus' name, Holy Spirit, I ask that every sinner watching would be saved for the glory of God. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." I'm going to preach a message today about several different people that I know personally that have had the touch of God, that's been saved and delivered by the blood of Jesus Christ. Jeff Fennell was the original lead singer and actor in the play and the movie Jesus Christ Superstar. He was also the lead singer of the black metal-heavy satanic rock group Black Sabbath. As a child, Jeff was beaten and neglected and abused. His dad deserted him, and his mother put him in the boys' prison. Jeff started stealing cars and fighting and joining street gangs and everything. And at the age of 12 years old, a psychiatrist told Jeff and old mother, "This boy has no love in his heart for anything or for anyone." He hated God and he blamed God. At the age of 12, Jeff Fennell formed his first rock and roll band. At the age of 15, he made his first hit record called Going Too Far. It made the top 40 charts, and his rock and roll group was the most popular in all the Midwest. At the age of 15, he also made his second album called 1,000 Devils. At the age of 16, Jeff was playing and singing to 3,000 to 4,000 young people a night, 7 days a week, making upwards of $1,000 a week. He moved out of his home, rented himself a nice apartment at the age of 16 years old. Jeff calls himself now a child of darkness. During his time on the road, he met other satanic rock and roll groups where they would drink human and animal blood in devil worship rituals. At the age of 20, Jeff was on the streets walking. He was high on crack cocaine and marijuana. He overheard a young street preacher preaching, and the young street preacher felt impressed with God to go up and tell Jeff Fennell that Jesus loved him. Jeff told that street preacher, he said, "Preacher, I'm going to hell with all of my friends, and when we get there, we're going to party. There is no God." The young preacher kept on talking to Jeff and finally persuaded Jeff Fennell to go to revival where he was preaching. Jeff Fennell went to that church, and he sat down, and the power of God came on Jeff Fennell. He ran to the altar crying because the presence of God got a hold of that young man. He had on leather jackets, leather pants, biker boots. He had gold chains on, diamond rings on. He had hair down to his waist. An old pharisaical legalistic preacher stood up and said, "Young man, you're not going to get saved in my church looking like that." He said, "Cut your hair. You look like a girl." Jeff Fennell's tears dried up. He got up and cussed that legalistic pharisaical preacher and stormed out of that church. Shortly thereafter, Jeff got the job of Jesus Christ Superstar. He started hearing voices in the night. Then the voices started speaking through him. He became demon-possessed. Then for some reason, he married a Christian woman who witnessed to him all the time. He would wake up in the next morning after going to sleep one night on El High. He would wake up with oil all over his forehead where she prayed for him. She would tell him Jesus loved him. He would beat her. She would tell him Jesus loves you. She miscarried 3 children because he beat her so severely. Yet that woman told him Jesus loved him. She would not give up on him. His wife hired a crew of Christian carpenters to come and remodel one of their homes. Jeff tried to intimidate, cuss, and fight and run them off. Nothing worked. They were long-haired, tattooed, ex-biker, ex-drug addicts, ex-mafia members, Christians who had been saved by the blood of Jesus Christ, and they feared nothing but God. Jeff finally let these men of God pray for him, and as soon as they said amen, he was delivered by the power of God. Jeff Fennell says he felt like an animal lifted off of his back when he accepted Jesus Christ as his Savior. Jeff Fennell is now a born-again child of God Christian who goes around the world singing about the love of Jesus Christ. He's been to 5 continents telling people that Jesus saves, Jesus saves, Jesus saves. I'm telling you today, Jesus saves. From the guttermost to the uttermost, Jesus saves. Help me to see in those I meet on country road or city streets, not just strange people passing by, but those for whom Christ came to die. Through his eyes of love and grace, let me find beauty in each face. Those very people passing by are those for whom Christ came to die. I'm telling you, Jesus saves, Jesus saves. John Newton was a pirate on the high seas of the Atlantic Ocean. He ran a slave ship and treated the slaves cruel and terrible. One day, Jesus Christ found John Newton and saved his doomed soul. And John Newton wrote the words of amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. What am I telling you, friend? I'm telling you, Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Reverend Gypsy Smith tells a story of a bunch of gypsies crossing a swollen stream of water where many of them drowned. He recalls one story where one young man tried to save his mother, and she kept clinging to him. He said, "Mother, let me go and I can save you." She would not let go and she drowned. At the funeral at the grave, the young man stood by his mother's grave and said, "Mother, if you would have only let go, I could have saved you. How hard I tried to save you, you would not let me." That's what God is telling you now. That's what Jesus Christ is telling you now. How hard God has tried to save you, you will not let him. You think that you're good enough. You think that you can make it on your own. You think you can join a Masonic lodge or a country club. You think you can do good works. The Bible says that you're not saved by good works. You're saved by grace. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto God but through it by me. There's no other name given under heaven among men whereby we must be saved other than the name of Jesus Christ." If you're going to make it to heaven, if you're going to get out of hell, you're going to have to go through Jesus Christ. Not through good works, not through a man, but only through Jesus Christ. What am I telling you? I'm telling you, Jesus saves. Rusty Welker was on death row in a South Carolina prison. As a child, he was neglected and abused. He ran away from home several times. He lived under bridges and in public restrooms. Bob McAllister was a prison guard and also a Christian at the South Carolina State Penitentiary. He found Rusty on death row, laying in a roach-infested cell, curled up in a fetal position, lifeless and loveless and hopeless. Bob tried to talk to Rusty several times about the love of Jesus Christ, week after week, month after month, and Rusty Welker never said a word. He never blinked an eye. Until one day when Bob came to that cell, he found Rusty sitting up and crying, and he prayed the sinner's prayer, and Rusty Welker was saved that very moment. As Rusty Welker was getting prepared to die by lethal injection, the woman that was getting him ready overheard Rusty say, "All I ever wanted was a home, and now I'm going to get one in heaven." You see, my friend, each one of us has a need to be loved. You have a need to be loved, and you're looking all in the wrong places. You're trying to find it in sex and drugs and alcohol and this and that and the other, and it's not working. Rusty Welborn found the love of God, and he now has a home in heaven because Jesus Christ loved him. What am I telling you? I'm telling you, Jesus saves. Jesus saves. Abraham Lincoln one day was watching a slave trader auction off a young, beautiful black lady. Her clothes were torn, her face was bloody, her back was beaten, she was bruised and battered. Something moved Abraham Lincoln's heart, and he began to weep. Then he started bidding on her. Someone would bid, Abraham Lincoln would bid higher, until finally the bidding stopped. Now she belonged to Abraham Lincoln. This scared young, beautiful black lady said, "Sir, what are you going to do with me now?" Abraham Lincoln said, "I'm going to set you free now." He said, "My dear, you're free to do as you please and go where you want to. I bought you so I can set you free." A tear trickled down that young black lady's face. She said, "Sir, I choose to stay with the one who set me free." You see, my friend, Jesus said, "I am the one that can set you free. He who the Son sets free is free indeed." You've tried Alcoholics Anonymous, you've tried drug rehabilitation, you've tried psychologists and psychiatrists and counselors. Nothing else works. It's time to try Jesus Christ. It's time to try the one that died on the cross of Calvary 2,000 years ago and shed his life's blood for me and for you. He's the one that can set you free. And once he sets you free, you will never want to leave him because he's the Son of God.
Yeah.
boy, if he's in him, I live, we would have my very being. He's the only one that can give you peace past understanding, joy unspeakable, full of glory. John Bunyan said that he had a heavy pack of sin strapped on his back. It caused him to be bent over, and no amount of shaking could shake that pack off. He tried to pay money to get people to buy that pack off. Nothing worked. One day he climbed up a hill called Golgotha and came to a place called Calvary, where a cross stood. When one drop of the Son of God's blood hit that pack of sin, his book said the pack of sin broke off and the pack hit the ground. Some of you have a monkey on your back. You've tried every way to get that thing off, but you cannot shake it off. You cannot buy money to get that pack off. It's time to try Jesus Christ. What am I telling you? I'm telling you, Jesus saved, Jesus saves. A very well-known preacher in the Middle Ages was going to preach a sermon on the proof of God's love. The church, the following night, the church house was packed that following night. Not even standing room in that congregation. He came and he told the elders and the deacons, he said, turn down all the lights. And this preacher brought in a little candle, and he also brought a picture of the crucified Christ. And all these people were expecting to hear a great expository sermon on the proof of God's love. He came in and all was dark except that little candle. He came to that picture. He held one time to the nail prints in his hand. Then to his forehead where the thorns were crushed. Then to his side where the spear had been wounded. He blew the candle out and walked out of that chapel. That was the minister's sermon on the proof of God's love. What am I telling you? I'm telling you, Jesus Christ died for your sins. He loves you. What are you going to do with Jesus, my friend? What are you going to do with Jesus? From this point on, you can no longer ignore him. From this point on, you can no longer discredit Jesus Christ. If you were to die right now, this very minute, where would you spend eternity? 1 billion years from right now, your soul's going to be in eternity somewhere. It's going to be heaven or hell. Right now, you're either saved or lost. Right now, you're a servant of God or you're a servant of the devil. Which one is it? Without Jesus Christ as your Savior, you're one heartbeat, one breath, one step from a fiery, burning, eternal hell. As sure as a stone sinks into the depths of the sea, will your soul plunge into an eternal hell without Jesus Christ as your Savior? The Bible says the smoke of their torment rolls up forever and ever, and they have no rest day or night in hell. The Bible says whosoever was found not written in the Lamb's book of life was cast into the lake of fire. You see, my friend, it is a fearful thing to fall into the hands of an angry God. A man gains the whole world and loses his own soul. What have you gained? Let me tell you something. The Bible says, Jesus says, God says, come now, let us reason together. Though your sins be as scarlet, they'll be as white as snow. Though they'll be red like crimson, they'll be as wool. Romans 10 says that if you confess the Lord Jesus Christ with your mouth, but even in your heart that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, ye will be saved. For whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. God's not wanting any to perish and die and go to hell, but he wants you to be saved. He wants your soul. He paid a high price for your soul. He paid a debt he did not owe, and you owe a debt you cannot pay. What are you going to do with Jesus Christ? For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life. That's how much God loves you. That's how much Jesus Christ loves you. I'm going to pray for you right now. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask you, Lord, to send this word forth with power and anointing. I ask you, Holy Ghost, to convict every sinner of their sin until they confess their sin, until they are converted from their sin. Holy Spirit, I ask you to loose and set them free. I bind and rebuke every addiction, every demonic bondage, every chain, every shackle, every fetter. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to loose them in the name of Jesus. Through the power of the blood of Jesus, I ask you to set them free. I ask you, Holy Spirit, to put such a desire in their heart to call on you now to save their soul from a doomed and damned and darkened hell. In the name of Jesus, Satan, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ, and I ask you right now to loose them and let them go in Jesus' name. Sinner friend, if you've gotten saved, I ask you to wipe me up, grab me one.